long-term cancer survivors who want to know where they stand from a fertility standpoint. They may or may not have been able to do sperm banking or another fertility preservation technique when they were younger, but they want to know what is the chance of them having kids. We can do some blood work to assess for testosterone deficiency, but really what it comes down to is doing a semen analysis. That's done in the andrology lab in conjunction with Dr. Vidge.
For the patients who do not have cryopreserved sperm or frozen sperm and are coming to me later in life in the survivorship mode, who do not have sperm in their ejaculate, so they've undergone a treatment that that essentially left them sterile, we can still do a sperm retrieval procedure. It's a testicular biopsy. We don't find sperm in all those men, but we do in a percentage. It depends a lot on the cancer treatment that they received. The sort of less extreme example of that might be someone who has very reduced counts. So they did resume some sperm production, but not to normalcy. And then it's a discussion about assisted reproduction and what options there are for them. Infertility is an important piece, but a healthy sex life and sex drive are all sort of important, you know, components of adulthood. I find that patients most of the time are just so relieved that you've asked the question because nobody has, and they may not even know that perhaps their erectile dysfunction is a result of a cancer treatment they received. So normalizing it for them, making them feel like, look, this is an important part of life and being alive is more important, but being alive and living a healthy, happy life matters.